Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this video I'm going to discuss about my Node.js project, that is authentication app. And basically in this project I have used the I have created the front end part, and then I authenticated using passport JS, passport JS basically yield a strategy Google Auth and passport local and JWT JSON web token strategy. Basically passport is just more than 500 strategy. I tried this, and now this assets basically contain the static file CSS, image or JavaScript codes. And this config file basically consists the code when our app runs, and the code that will execute when we are opening the app. Then that code we are going to place in config file. Connection.js is the code to connect with the database, and when we start our application, then it will automatically configure and it will connect to the database. This is the custom middleware with setting flash. This is the node mailer. Basically it is the module in npm, and it is basically provides easiness to send mail to our client. And this is the strategy called passport Google strategy, passport JWT strategy, passport local strategies. And controllers, basically these are the set of functions which does particular task or process any request. This project is based on MAC architecture, model view controller. Whenever a client, or you can say when you browsing, when you type google.com, then that request, basically we are typing google.com is a request, and this request basically goes to router basically select the controller based on our request and sends that request to that controller, and controller basically process the request and send the response. And along with response, if there is data required, then it interacts with database and fetch data, and then sends data to view. Basically view is we are using the template library, ES embedded JavaScript, so that it makes our static page to dynamic. And this is the mailer folder, which consists of configuration of node mailer. We don't need to write that much code to send mail. It is already written here. We have created the transporter. Now this folder basically containing the code related to send mail, and in configuration folder we are defining the transporter for sending mail, and the models basically containing the schema for database. We are storing the used MongoDB, so here we have to define a schema. A schema basically nothing but a structure. When we want to store email token, suppose we want to store some information email, we want to store, we have to give type a string, required true means, so the it must be required while filling, while when we are submitting something, there must be an email. Node model basically it is the npm models, and it comes with npm init, and this is the routers, and it contain the codes. This is the router.js. This contains all the route, when we are getting router, basically it tells us select the controller. We are clicking on some button and we write it to sign up, then it will tells to select the controller sign up sign up controller, and whatever the process we have created, whatever the function we have written, it will execute. And this is view directory, which consists of like EJS files. And EJS file basically embedded JavaScript. And this .env file consists of the secret. Like we don't want to something to expose to our client. When someone expect, he should not see something like our secret password or something like that. We are putting in .env file. And this is .gitignore. This file is created for like something we don't want to push in our Git, like node modules. When there are more dependencies or we have installed more modules in our project, then it becomes heavy. So we don't want to push in Git repository, because when we are doing npm init, it will install all the dependencies. And this is index.js. This is the main, we can say it is app.js. It configures all the code, whatever we have written. We required all the modules that is required for our app. And we have configured all the middlewares, all the things in our index.js. This package log.js. This is the basically information about the dependencies of dependency. It is the kind of tree structure for dependencies. And package.json contains all the information about our project, project name, version description, and all the dependencies modules like connect flask, connect mongo. These are all dependencies. Contain all the information. readme.md, it is basically the file which is present in our Git repository. And it is basically information about the app, like how we are configuring, how we can start, how we can set up. This all the information present in readme file. That's all about. Thank you.